Espresso. From this point forward in our show, everything is performed and run by junior high students. Grades 7 to 9 students also played a big role in helping with set construction and painting. The coffee bar was built by the grade 9 students in Mr. Pop's IA class. Now doesn't that look fantastic?
Is there anything wrong? Did it make perfect? Oh no, it's perfect. So perfect, your business must be booming.
Alas, business has slowed down considerably ever since a man named Vulcan Vanbrugh caught the current town.
I just can't imagine you having a slow day. The Pony Express store has always had a nice atmosphere. The finest coffee. And star.
Surprisingly, Mr. Bennington sells coffee for only 2 cents. We can't figure out if we can offer at such a low price, not go to business. After all, we have to cover expenses.
I just don't know what Aunt Dad would do if our business would fail. Even though we have a few pennies saved, we want to go towards a watch wherever escape room. Something Auntie always dreamed to have us.
My heart aches when I see Star suffering. Don't worry, Star. Nothing could ever happen to Pony Expresso. You've always had dedicated customers. Gosh, you know me. I'd never go to another place for my cup of coffee. So, where are all the other customers?
Unfortunately, our relatives have mysteriously fallen sick. What an incredibly strong man. He stayed healthy until he felt failing health. In fact, Barbara's sunk this strange illness has struck both Master Blade's ranch hands.
Has he tried any lotion on his hands?
I mean, filled turf in our spot.
I wish I could help, Master. My day's already full.
How so?
Dunkin' Donut has me working hard, rounding up his cattle at the hole-in-one ranch. It's a full-time job. However, I could work a nest to see if I can solve this mystery. I'm up anyway.
Why, Bug? How brave, how valiant, how courageous! That's wonderful they're willing to help our ailing town.
Shucks, man. It's really nothing to face a mysterious illness.
Could this be a time to speak of love? Guess not.
Mere Coffee, thank you for coming to the Pony Expresso. How may we serve you?
I'm sorry, Star. I'm not here to relax. I'm here to warn the both of you. Another person fell ill in our fine community.
Oh my, who?
My wife, honey. She suddenly dropped ill, became dizzy and turned green as a frog. I thought she might even croak.
Auntie, come quickly!
What's all the commotion about?
Honey Foxy struck down with a mysterious illness.
Oh my, will she be okay?
I don't know. Doc Cappuccino is still out at the Plain Ranch. Hopefully she'll be back soon. The town's in an uproar. As mayor, I'm supposed to keep everything under control. With the elections coming up, this search will not help my chances. Sometimes I feel like I'm twitching at the bottom of the ocean.
Ma, you are a nervous wreck.
Get it? Nervous wreck? Twitching at the bottom of the ocean?
Mayor Coffee, I thought you were the only one running for office.
Not anymore. Vulcan Bennett's put his name on the ballot. And with this horrible medical problem in town, I'm going to receive a lot of complaints for not handling it right.
But the fact that people are falling ill and Doc Cappuccino can't figure it out isn't your fault.
Doc has checked out everything. She's even suggested foul play.
How frightening!
What does Sheriff Goldstone have to say about all this?
Unfortunately, I gave the sheriff permission to take a 2-week paid vacation to escape the stresses and strains of his job.
What was happening to him?
Said he saw a three-legged dog walk into his office.
What's so bad about that?
Sheriff Goldstone claims the dog spoke to him. Said the dog was looking to find who shot his paw.
Oh, my.
When those kind of things go on in your town, Sheriff, you know it's time to give them a break. But I did not realize things would go wrong all at the same time. I'm afraid our community is without a man of law.
Is there anyone who can take his place?
A strong, confident man?
Brave and bold. We all know who fits these descriptive words.
Bug, do you think?
Don't worry, y'all. Mayor Coffee, swear me in.
Bug, raise your right hand. Do you promise to uphold the law of Water Pit?
I do.
My hero!
Then I officially give you the title of temporary sheriff.
As temporary sheriff, I vow to find an answer to why Water Pit is experiencing these illness problems. I will immediately go tell Mr. Donut that I'm now a temporary sheriff and I'll be taking a short leave of absence. Star, I hope we can talk more. We are not in the midst of chaos in our town.
Fuck, I'll talk to you anytime, anywhere. Anyways, I know it's not the real truth. And thank you for your continued patronage, Pony Expresso.
Excuse me? May I interrupt this magic moment and ask your assistance?
Why, certainly, Mayor Coffee.
What can we help you with?
With Honeyill, I need someone to take care of my sugar and spice.
Twins, born on Tuesday? It would be my pleasure.
And with business being as slow as it is, I'm sure I can lend a helping hand, too.
I take care of them myself, but for some reason I've been a bit nervous around them lately.
Why?
Doc says it might be because of the pear, Anoia. I'm sure I'll feel better once her mother's back on her feet.
When will I get started?
Now. Sugar, spice,
the coffee maker. Sugar, the sweet one, and spice. Good tasting, everything she does.
Hello, Miss Bright. Hello, Miss Cat.
Hello, children. Your dad would like you to stay here while he solves some big problems.
May we have our first cup of coffee later, Doc? Please? Pretty please?
With sugar on top?
No, we don't want sugar on top. She might get burnt.
You're still a mad young. When you're in the rugged west for a few more years, then I'll let you have your first taste.
They grow up so fast.
Coffee is one of the fun things we do out here. In fact, it was a great time playing outside.
Goody, goody.
Children, your daddy is going to work on that little problem. Thank you so much for everything.
No problem, Mayor Coffee. You have such beautiful children. Though, it's sometimes hard to tell them apart.
And it's a good idea to keep those youngins in a safe environment with all this illness going around. You kids behave yourselves.
We will, Daddy.
Time to play.
Yeah! What are we gonna play?
How about some horseshoes?
Wow, I love playing horseshoes.
While Miss Brown and I set up the stakes, you two can take the shoes off of our horse, Swiss Miss.
Isn't that dangerous? Could you get kicked?
Don't worry. Swiss Miss is a stable animal.
What color is she?
Why, she's the color of chocolate, of course. Let's go on out and meet her.
Here it is, the perfect place to put the Cabana coffee cart. And it certainly will be the ideal dwelling for me, the powerful Mayor Mo Cabana. Ha ha ha!
But Mo, do you really expect them to sell so establishment?
Why not? Their business is crumbling with the Cabana coffee cart close dry. Look around here. Do you see any customers? Curses! Their coffee is really quite good.
What's wrong with that?
Don't you see what this means? She's so dumb. A mind reader would only charge her half price. It means it may take months to force them out of business. But perhaps I can use my good looks to persuade them to sell this place. At a bargain price, of course. Do you agree?
Oui, you're delightfully talented.
And dazzling. And deceitful, dishonest, and just not very nice.
Now keep quiet. I have some negotiating for you.
How beautiful. Perhaps I want something more than the cocktail, but a kiss from this lovely lady would be a deal in itself.
Welcome to the Pony Expresso. How may we serve you?
By giving us just a few seconds of your time. We're here on business.
Now I recognize you. You're Mo Cabana, the one that runs a coffee cart.
Correct. And this is Fifi Latte, my assistant.
It is my pleasure to meet you.
This is Boss.
I'm Sugar.
I told you they're hard to tell apart. This is Sugar, and this is Boss.
That's all very nice. And it even rhymes.
Such stupid one.
Silence. We have business to attend to. I hope we're not disturbing you.
We're quite busy. I'm giving Sugar and Spice a treat for the horse food sportsmanship, while I'm deep into shoes back on Swiss Miss.
I hate to interrupt this incredible moment in the little girl's lives, but these are very important business matters we need to discuss. Perhaps CP can escort these two little tykes over to the ice cream shop. My treat, of course.
Me? Take Zemba's the ice cream?
Of course. Remember, you've always told me how much you love children. Here's your chance to treat two precious little girls who just played a rugged game of horseshoes to an ice cream sundae.
This is Saturday.
Well, then get them an ice cream Saturday. More importantly, get them ice cream. Now, if she continues to be an imbecile, I'll have to ask her to stop helping me.
Mr. Cabana, do you seem rather passionate about this matter? I promise these children a piece of beef jerky. They are very deserving.
They could have beef jerky ice cream.
Please let us go, Miss Bright.
Ice cream sounds really yummy. Please, please, please.
Well, okay. but I want to do a group trip to the ice cream shops and back. I would go with the children, except someone has to watch the shop while Dee puts her shoes back on Swiss Miss.
Then we mustn't waste time. Have a wonderful treat. In fact, take your time. Ah, my sweet. Now we're going to talk business.
I feel uncomfortable talking about business without my Aunt Dee here.
Come now. We wouldn't want to interrupt your important task. And it's nothing much.
Perhaps right. So, well, what do I talk about?
We are both involved with coffee.
Yes, go on.
You must admit, selling coffee has its perks.
And so brings you here. Obviously, not a cup of coffee.
I'm sure that my successful endeavor is draining you. I don't mean to be offensive or hurt your feelings, but the Pony Express wouldn't stand a chance against my cart. With all this happening, it would be easy to assume that you're interested in selling your business to me.
Never! The coffee freshman is still in the best brand decaf me. We'll never sell out.
I realize that for many, coffee has been the grounds of many a heated discussion. But come now, my dear. It's more logical to get money out of your failing business before you lose everything.
The day will never come. It will never happen. And Dina, have been money saved to fight you for months.
Maybe I could convince her to marry me. That would mean a profitable merger in more ways than one. Maybe we should become better acquainted instead of a merger between our two companies. I'm sure you'd see it's mutually beneficial. Being the next mayor of Waterpit, who can doubt I am Waterpit's man of the future?
Mr. Cabana, I can never work with you, much less vote for you. Nothing but a cheap politician who will never be elected mayor of Waterpit.
I don't see why you call me a cheap politician. After all, I'm going to cost this town a fortune. My dear, I stand on my record.
So no one can see it.
Be reasonable, Miss Bright. I elect to give you a scrumptious kiss. Not only will this convince you to vote for me, but surely we are made for each other, like coffee beans and water.
Stay away from me, sir. You realize I'm in hot water.
Let me have a kiss from those lovely lips.
Never. Especially when I'm both in political techniques. And dreadful coffee breath. Let go of me! Take that!
How dare you! Look what you've done to my shirt. To repay me for this shirt, you now owe me a kiss.
Help! Help! Help!
What's happening here?
Help me, dear book, help me!
A hand grenade, villain.
What's going on in here?
There are both members of an inappropriate marketing campaign tactics on me.
You can. As a stalwart man, I'm inclined to trounce you good. However, as a gentleman and temporary sheriff, I'll let you off with a warning. I don't have time to deal with the chief good for nothing. It's vowed that I spend my time solving a serious community crisis.
This is an outrage. You should arrest her. When she spilled coffee in this shirt, she showed me disdain. Disdain, de-stain. Okay, that was a bit of a stretch.
And this day may never come out, Mr. Cabana. And you can blame her improper advances.
Mr. Cabana, leave here at once. You are no longer welcome at the Pony Express.
Sugar, spice, thank goodness you're back. And you as well are no longer welcome to Pony Espresso.
What's it that I do? I'm eating some fuzzy ice cream Saturday. What's at school?
You're associated with this brew.
Yeah, what a mess. What happened to you? Yeah, what happened to you?
None of your business, you unsightly roommates.
I think they're cute.
I see. When they were born, the stork was fired.
Hold your tongue, Snake. You might as well. Your political career is already over.
I assure you I'll find a way to dispose of the Pony Espresso. After all, Mo Cabana never backs down when it comes to his affairs.
Whoa! Howdy, everyone. Hope I ain't intruding.
Don't worry, Polly and Polly. These two vagabonds were just leaving.
Mo Cabana shall return!
Goodbye, little sweetheart.
Star and Miss Dee, I have a feeling there's something strange about those two. I'd stay away from them if I were you.
Don't worry, Book. We're forever to save Swan's your temporary shirt.
But Dog Cappuccino, isn't there anything you can do?
I'm sorry, Mayor. This one's out of my territory. Unless we can find the source of the poison, it's the way to ground. Just to make sure they're comfortable.
Have you ever seen anything this mysterious before?
I once had a man come and say he was drinking.
What did you do?
Clint Viking.
Told him he had to be a little patient.
This thing here is mighty strange. I think there's something behind it.
Do you think this could be?
Yes, I think it's foul play.
Foul
chicken they're eating isn't good?
No! I mean, someone's making them ill on purpose.
Who would do such a horrible thing?
If I found out who's doing this, I'll throw him in jail.
What would be the charge?
No charge. Getting him to jail is free.
So what do we owe the visit, Palomino?
$2 and Pony Overnight Express.
A real Pony Express rider? We've never been this close to one.
She even sounds like a pony.
How's that?
She's a little horse.
She's been around horses all the time. Horses are always on Main Street.
True. We have not horses on a ranch, so I play with the pigs.
Why?
I guess they like to be neighbors.
It's nice living on a ranch with all that hospitality. I love to live a life like that.
What did you do before you rode for the Pony Express?
I used to have a riding academy, but business just kept falling off. The horses kept hiding behind the trees to change their jockeys. I even tried to open up a horse dance academy, but horses just can't dance.
Why not?
Because they have two left feet. And one day, all my horses got bad colds.
What did you give them?
Cough syrup!
Palomino, you should be fighting me down. Do now. In fact, you're one of the fastest riders around.
Almost that to my horse, Storm. A horse like Storm can ride like lightning with the reins. Don't blame me, folks. I didn't write the script. I just delivered the message.
I see no letter in your hands there, Palomino. Who's it for?
Just happens to be for you. It says right here, decaf.
It's from the president.
President?
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 Oh, of the Central Pacific Railroad.
What does it say?
It's a bit blurry for me. Star, could you read this?
Have your eyes ever been checked?
No, they've always been brown. To whom it may concern, the United States government and Central Pacific Railroad will continue to serve a great country by joining the two oceans of our nation. Your establishment has been designated as official railroad stop point. Will take significant amount of speed and allow you to change your current business. Thank you for your help. Sincerely, H.L. Scale.
The Pony Express is from as valuable as gold mines.
I don't believe it.
I don't believe it.
We don't believe it.
We don't believe it.
Is there an echo in here?
What's wrong, Palomino?
With the railway coming through, it looks like I'm out of a job.
Oh, my.
We didn't mean to hurt anybody.
Don't worry. I'm not hurt, just unemployed.
And speaking of hurt and employment, I still have my position as temporary sheriff. There's a mystery to be solved.
Maybe next time we'll have more time to chat.
That would be wonderful. In fact, maybe we can even take a walk, just two of us. Why can't I just tell Star I love her?
That would be wonderful! But how long can it be till it hears words of affection?
Time of celebration for you, Palomino. But would you care to join us down at the ice cream shop?
That's awful nice of you, Dee. But I reckon I might go around town looking for a new job. I guess it's time for Palomino to move on once again.
Poor Palomino.
Doesn't mean that you still can't celebrate. This time could use a little happiness.
So how about it then? How about another trip on down to the ice cream shop?
Wow, again?
I don't see one on.
Hooray!
Hold up for a cup of hot coffee after being on the hot sun, but I suppose I can go for some ice cream.
Well, let's go then. It's on me. You lock the front door, I'm coming back to the shop. With so many strange things happening in the pit, I don't take any chances.
What dastardly misfortune this is for me. The Pony Express is now worth far more than a few cups of coffee. Their success and influence demolish any chance I had being elected mayor and personal financial empire.
Also, making it out of letters.
If she had greatness thrust upon her, she destined became with directions.
Are you going to do anything? I can't mess around with the U.S. government and an entire railroad. But on the other hand, I'm up to that kind of challenge.
Mo, this could be our time to forget the life of crime. We could start our own coffee shop and work for a living.
Where did you come up with that idiotic idea? Work is the most ridiculous way of making money.
His name could be Theory since he never works. The little twins made me realize that an honest family life may not be that bad.
Curses! She's getting as soft as marshmallow and hot chocolate. Gotta watch my step around her. Ridiculous! Selling coffee is a daily grind. It's the money from the Central Pacific Railroad that will make us rich. Most of all, it will make me rich. Give us the life of luxury. Give me the life of luxury. Maybe there's something we can do.
And that is?
I never thought I would have to use this.
Isn't that the same wicked poison things that we've been putting in the coffee on the cart?
Let's just say it's the same. I just happen to brew this bottle a little stronger. Or should I say a lot stronger?
But you mean who's those little children?
Who cares about those little children? I just want to do it before they all get back.
Well, how we get out of here? Both the doors are locked.
I found this spare key behind the counter. No one can doubt I'm as smart and cunning as a sly fox.
But Mo, it seems they may be on the right track. This temporary sheriff will not stop until he finds who's making the town and the weather.
How can you even doubt me? To her, brains aren't everything. In her case, they're nothing. How can you even doubt me? That with the real sheriff away and that temporary sheriff trying to solve things, this place will soon be ours. As long as we do it right, and no one, like you, spills the beans.
Is that their... is your stress level?
Thank you.
Thank you. She'll enjoy our visit as well. Though, I'm concerned I might have dropped some coins in the batter.
Oh my, what could that do?
Well, it might make the cake too rich.
I'm sure it'll be okay. After all, Mary Cox says life's getting better.
You know, people are like tea bags. Sometimes you just have to put them in hot water to see how strong they are. And I know that honey coffee has the spirit and strength to survive. Speaking of strong, I'm going to make sure we have an extra strong cup of coffee for everybody coming in today.
Not too strong. We still need one buck with 6 cups of coffee. Now, doesn't that look charming? Auntie, our spare key is missing. Should I call the locksmith? He's our key man in a situation like this.
I wouldn't worry about it. It probably just slipped into one of the counter cracks. We'll look for it later. Right now, the best to get going to see Honey Coffee during her visiting hours. Just make sure the back door and the front door are locked. I don't want any mysterious sorts coming in through here while we're gone.
Don't worry. I know the Pony Express will secure her doors locked and temperature buck in our community.
Finally, those fools have left. Little do they know this key works just as well going in as it does going out.
This is not right. This plan is much too evil.
Nothing can ever be too evil, and you are now fortunate to be part of something especially abominable. But just remember, if anything happens to me, I'll make sure everyone knows you're in on this too.
I'll have to do something about her once I'm in control of the Pony Expresso.
I refuse to do anything.
Just knowing that I'm here makes you an accomplice. So just shut up and watch me add a bit of zesty, venomous seasoning to the coffee. Ha ha ha! I'm now a seasoned veteran. This coffee is only good for its sedimental value. One sip from this poison pot and you're in the grounds.
You have gone a step too far.
You can never take too many steps when obtaining money. When I stole the ladder, I knew additional steps could be taken.
Aha, very funny. What are you going to do now?
Don't worry, I'm handling everything.
You are mad. Your only plan is to be evil.
The point is that I am brilliantly evil. Things always come together from Old Cabana, and nothing is going to stop me from making a fortune when the railroad comes to town.
Egad, this fee idiot is losing her train of thought. I don't want her taking me down the wrong track.
Yikes! I've got to get you out of here before she spoils everything. Hurry, go!
You can't make me.
If you want those little ones you care so much to be safe, you'll leave now.
You can't!
Now who could that be?
Certainly glad I was able to catch you, Mandy.
No problem. I'll get you your morning cup.
That's not really why I wanted to see you. It has to do with something else. I needed to ask you something kind of privately.
You know, I was kind of surprised when you asked me to come here instead of Star.
Well, I've been thinking a lot about your niece.
Yet, you've never asked her out. You know, girls who aren't outside eventually tend to feel outdated.
I'm on the Pony Express where every day's been like a million dates with Star. Talking with her, looking into her twinkling eyes, drinking the coffee she makes special for me. If only I could experience her kiss.
At least I came close.
So, what can I help you with?
Well, I figure I should do this as proper as any man should, so here goes. May I have Star's hand in marriage?
Her hand? Buck, you can have all of her. I'd be proud to have you as my nephew-in-law.
Don't know how much longer I'll be in law. After all, being temporary sheriff is not known to be a long-time position.
Well, whatever you do after your temporary sheriff job, I know you will make a great husband.
Thank you, Dee. That means a lot to me. Now, I reckon I should go make my rounds around town, and then I'll find Star and ask her.
And that imbecile is always making things more difficult for me.
And I best be getting going to see Honey Coffee's reaction to her pot of gifts. I can hardly wait to hear of your proposal.
I can hardly wait to propose.
This is terrible! With Buck and Star together, it's next impossible for me to take over the Pony Expresso. Now is the time for me to use even more of my ingenious ability to do evil. A little bit of forgery never hurt anyone. When I was posing as a blacksmith and stealing horses, I used to forge strong links with the customers. Yikes, can't I get any privacy around this place? After all, it's practically mine.
I'm glad we're heading over to the coffee house. Seems like this hour's going so quickly. Miss Coffee loves her flower products and beans. Buck and Joe's cup of coffee? Is my coffee that bad that he prefers a cup from Aunt Dee instead?
Oh, I know he did. I say we celebrate the fact that Honey Coffee's coming out of sticky illness by having a cup of Pony Espresso coffee.
We should
have
won that way.
That's awfully kind of you, Dee. And I've got to thank all of you for your campaign support. In fact, as water pits return to mayor, I plan on building a two-story courthouse.
Why?
Because I like high offices.
I want to do a mayor. He had a parrot to hold a watch.
Oh my, how's the parrot?
Six. I want my cow to swallow a spoon.
Did the cow die?
Hasn't stirred since.
Someone was probably a pig and it couldn't make a sound.
What was your diagnosis?
It was disgruntled.
Oh my gosh, where are my sugar and spice?
Don't worry about them. They're playing the back.
Are they safe? Some horses can cause people a lot of whoa.
Don't worry, Mayor Coffee. Your children are really great with horses.
Speaking of great, it's 1 feet here, Barb.
How'd you get off work? Since Phil and Rusty are finally back on their feet, Mass Burnham needs me at the ranch.
What are you going to do now? Okay?
Don't worry about me. I knew this would be coming sooner or later. I'm confident I'll find something to do that'll help me sell a water pit. After all, you folks are the best friends this could ever ask for. So I'd like to make a toast to my family of water pit.
Howdy, everyone.
It's the Operation
Buck. Hello, Buck. Are you concerned the poison?
Been on my horse all day. Haven't gotten any leads.
He must be exhausted. Can I get you a cup of coffee?
That would be wonderful. I don't think I can drink much more of that black stuff. I tell her, I don't want to hurt her feelings.
Thank you.
I can only hope it's as good as he deserves.
Much obliged, Star.
Seems to me that everything has settled down. Hopefully my honey will be buzzing about the house in no time.
Whatever it was, hit her pretty hard. I wouldn't rush her back to hell.
Bill and Rusty, they don't work hands, back in their feet.
They obviously made a fast recovery.
Just like a full-time water pit.
I wouldn't be too sure about that. We still haven't figured out who or what's behind the poisoning.
I just think it's important to think positive.
I agree. I'm not going to be able to drop a water pit unless I'm thinking positive. So I'd like to make another toast. Here's to thinking positive.
Miss Fred, Miss Cat!
Spice, can't you see the adults are talking?
Brian, sugar.
They're so difficult to tell apart.
Sorry, Daddy.
We just want to tell them about what the garden is planted.
A garden?
You are his case to be dismissed.
That's a lot of responsibility, girls.
Don't worry, we're good gardeners.
We'll certainly weed him and reap.
You know, I'm proud of both of you. You're both sprouting with maturity.
And carrots are mighty important for those eyes. Bad eyes are awfully costly.
How so?
I once had a patient who had four boys. All of them bad eyesight. They found sunglasses mighty expensive.
Taking on this new venture shows me that my little girls are growing up.
Does that mean Sugar and I can have our first cup of coffee?
Please, please, please. You and Miss Cap are saying we're growing up. Well, sort of.
Well.
Please, Daddy.
I'll let your kids have a sip. You can have the first.
Why does she always get to be the first one?
Because she's older.
Only by 3 minutes. It's not fair.
To make things fair, you can have a sip out of mine. Then you both can have a sip at the exact same time.
Sugar, Spice. Why don't you each make a little toast?
Is there any bread around here?
She needs to say a few inspirational words.
Oh.
Like this. To our favorite horse, I give her a kiss, a pucker mops, and smooch dear Swiss Miss.
Oh, I get it. Here's the greatest horse that's in every Swiss Miss. One was one race horse, two one race one, two one race, one 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 two.
Stop!
What's wrong?
The coffee could be too hot and burn their young mouths.
Not at the pace this seems crawling along at.
I'll take the first sip just to make sure everything's okay. I may not like drinking coffee, but I can never let harm come to these two innocent maidens.
A toast! A toast!
As temporary sheriff, here's to the Pony Espresso. Let their coffee quench your thirst. They'll always treat you right, and it's here that safety's first.
Anything like that.
How did you even know the note was behind the counter?
I saw Buck and Dee together just minutes ago. When Buck left, I was able to meet with Dee, and she showed me this letter. When I handed her back this horrible letter, I saw her sit behind the counter. I begged you not to do anything and went against the laws of our fine land. When you refused to listen, I immediately went to go to our temporary sheriff. But unfortunately, I was too late. But however, I can help by informing the railroad about our town's problems. They'll certainly want me to run the Pony Expresso.
Let me see that. I just don't believe it. It's my handwriting.
Because you wrote it, you scheming villainous?
And you never do such a thing. Buck Braun, love the temporary sheriff. Here lie, he'll find the real truth. Oh, Buck, if only your life was solved this horrible crime. Oh, Buck, I love you. I love you. I love you.
Could this be a dream?
Buck, you're alive!
It's a dream come true.
What's this? A voice from the dead?
He's alive!
Holy cow!
He's come back to life!
Hooray!
It's a miracle!
This can't be true!
It's true. I couldn't let you do this, Mo.
Do what?
He wanted to dispose of temporary Sheriff Braun. I couldn't let him do such a scene with all the innocent ones in the world. I switched the bottles.
This can't be true! We all saw the man die right before our very eyes.
Please allow me to do a medical examination. I'm happy to say this man did not die. He just has a horrible coffee allergy.
Coffee allergy?
Yes, a coffee allergy.
What do you recommend I do?
I recommend you drink a bucket of water.
Drinking a whole bucket of water would make me turn pale.
Then I suggest you need to drink tea.
Thank you, doctor.
You scoundrel!
Mo Cabana, you're under arrest.
That's ridiculous. You can't arrest me. You're a Pony Express rider, not a sheriff.
Not so, Cabana. I've been after you for years. You're not just talking to Palomino Polly. You're talking to Marshall Palomino Polly.
Marshall Palomino Polly?
Of the Pergola Territory. Hands up, Cabana.
It's not over yet. Either you let me out of this town free and easy, or I'll pour the rest of this poison down Star's throat.
You're a hideous fiend! You won't have any milk of human kindness if you drink a cow.
You started at the bottom and sank.
You never did a zin in your life, and you didn't do it that way.
You're all right, your place, but they haven't dug it yet.
Enough of the compliments. We're gonna take that horse over back to head to the hills.
Leave Swiss Miss out of this.
She is ready to you!
Nothing, villain.
Wait, go on!
Tracking down this scoundrel, I'd be proud to. My first duty will be to take this troublemaker and put him behind bars.
You might as well take me too, Sheriff Palomino. I'm guilty of doing the bad things too.
But you also care about my children. Sheriff, honey?
You can just call me Sheriff.
Talking about my wife, honey. Honey and I are still in some need of help at home. I think Fifi would make an excellent nanny.
Are you sure? That'd be wonderful.
I suppose I can release her into your custody.
Hooray!
Would you like to go outside and play horses?
Can we plant a garden instead?
But
plenty of carrots.
Anything you want.
In the back, I saw a rich shovel low.
And I saw a silver hoe high.
Then let's go pentagram.
Let's go, you rogue.
I'm tired of crime on the streets. Next time, I'll make house call.
Hello there.
Shall you are here to check up on Honey? Are you sure if you follow it to Manny?
I know it won't get her, nope.
Star, is it true you really kiss me?
My lips were upon your cheek.
Will you marry me, Star?
She can only say yes on one condition.
What's that?
With all the new business coming through the railroad, we're going to need some extra help. Buck, would you consider joining our family business?
It would be an honor. However, I couldn't start until I found a replacement as Duncan Jones' ranch hands.
Bart could do it.
Great idea. How about it, Bart?
Wow, that would be great. I'll just hop on Java and we'll go introduce ourselves.
And I guess I'll go check the inventory of beans and leave you two alone.
Oh yes, Buck, I'll marry you, but I too have one condition.
What's that?
Since we're no longer be the Pony Express stop for Water Pit, I can share our shop a new name.
What's that?
Buck Stars Coffee.
And tea. I think your name should come first.
That's sweetie, but who's ever heard of Starbucks? I think Buck Stars has a nice ring to it.
Speaking of a ring, my Star?
My book!